You paid the money in December, January. You left the office in April. April.
April.
That was 3 months after.
Yes, please.
Who, after you, who came in?
The substantive accounting officer.
It was a moment of tension as officials, including former top executives from the beloved Uganda National Roads Authority, Unra, struggled to find their bearings on billions of shillings meant to compensate persons and projects affected by the road's construction. The 47 billion shillings was advanced to contractors, but no clear monitoring mechanism followed thereafter.
You ask Honorable Elijah, how did you develop that aspect of giving the money to the contractors?
The idea of advancing money to the contractors was developed in-house within UNRA. It was discussed within management. At that time, we thought it was a good idea.
The task also did not in any way serve the then director planning, Engineer Limba Zisali, who was responsible for land compensations.
It was prudent that we have money in the contracts, so that pubs are paid on time, thereby would be able to reduce the delays in the delivery of projects, cut back the losses government was making out of contractors making claims against government for delays because pubs could not be paid so that they can be able to execute their work.
Even if the officials struggled to explain the modalities, the committee thinks what was done was illegal.
But what was being done was, it may have a good motive, but the problem was the aspect of monitoring that account. And yet the contract was saying open an independent impressed account, which those Chinese in their own way did it. They did it. They had an impressed account. But the problem came from UNRA, that UNRA never took an initiative to monitor it.
The question now is, with all the embezzlement of such sums to illegal contractors, what is the plight of the Ugandan taxpayer? Jocelyn Achibule, Dan Lugema, WBS TV, Parliament.